just a winter ride here in Ottawa. Oh, it sounds much better. I took the reflectors off the wheels. Listen to that, eh? Those brakes got to warm up a little bit. But, yeah, doing all right here. Brakes are definitely a little on the wet side. I gotta say, I'm still getting used to driving a bicycle. The dynamics are different on a bike. Go places and do shit. You can't do things like this on a motorbike. I love this thing though. Goes like a rocket. Much more balanced sound in the tires without those stupid big huge reflectors on it. Today's kind of going to be a little bit of my range test, per se. I'm going to take it all the way down to the river, up to the lookout. Going to have a pause that medicates. I'm going to talk about the bike all along the way. What do I like so far? What do I not like so far? So far, what do I like? It's an electric bike, man. What can you not like about that? It's easy. It's cool. It's pretty comfortable. Gets good speed. Battery charges up pretty quick. Works really well. There's no problems with it. It doesn't make any weird grinding noises, nothing like that. Now, I am going to say, if you've looked at other RideStar Q20 review videos, you've definitely seen people complain, or heard people complain, about the front shock bottoming out really easily. And I am here to attest to the fact that that is the truth. The whole truth and nothing but the truth. The front shock, you're going to hear it any moment, the front shock bottoms out. Just ridiculous, silly, easy. It's so, bottoms out so easy. I am riding here with absolutely no aim. I don't know where I'm going. I thought I was going to the river. I guess I am. I gotta head that way though. It's different on a bicycle. Because I can stay on the friggin' sidewalks and, you know. The motorbike doing this stuff, it's a different scenario. I'm not used to doing the off-road thing again. I'm also not sure if you guys can hear me, so I really don't know if I should be yapping. Come on, move, you fucking dummy. Some people just stare at you. You give them fucking motions and tell them to move, and they just look at you like you're on glue. Huh? What do I do? I keep forgetting I'm not a fucking motorbike. Get on the goddamn sidewalks. I can do that now. I'm going to go off-road again. Yeah. I don't know where I'm going. I'm just out for a rip. Little exercise. Little fun on the bike. What are you doing? Well, it's kind of where I wanted to be going anyway in the roundabout scheme of things, you know? Didn't bring my lock. Not stopping anywhere. So again, I don't know if you can hear me doing this or not. If you can't, I'll just do a voiceover. when I get home later. Yeah, much better without those stupid ass fucking reflectors on the front. Much better. Watch out for people here though. I love this electric pedal assist. I wasn't sure I'd be using the pedals at all. I find that I'm just naturally using them. No gas. Electric. Got a bike path. Oh, and it's been cleared. Holy shit. Well, not really. Block me. Watch. Gonna block right in front of me. What you fucking doing, you? The pedal assist gets you up to speed a whole lot quicker. I'm a bicycle. I'm not a motorbike. Hard to get used to now. Easier to get used to if I just stay on the sidewalk, I suppose. Smash into Central Africa here, who don't know where he's going. Funny, the electric scooter? Dogs want to chase me like a fucking, like crazy. Yeah, I'm gonna have to voice over the audio here. I'm swearing too much. Good stop.
Cheers. Update, 50 kilometer review on the Ridstar Q20. Man, this thing is a lot of fun. It is so much fun. Okay, gripes, likes. I mean, man, it's electric. What is there just to not like? Gripes? Okay, gripes. Here's the gripes that I've got after 50 kilometers. These bar end thingies here, they're slippy. They need to be, I got to upgrade those. Shock, rear shock, and front shocks. Absolutely, definitely need to be upgraded. Absolutely, definitely need to be upgraded. I bought them out on them left, right, and center. I'm 200 pounds. I shouldn't really, I mean, I'm not that heavy for the bike, but I shouldn't be bottoming out on it. Any other gripes? Nah, not really at all. I'm having so much fun on this thing. It goes like a rocket, 50 kilometers an hour. I'm testing range today, see what I can get out of it, and I'm really happy with it. It handles everything in the winter, no problem. I will say though, it's kind of torquey. It'll get away from you real quick on the rear wheel. Get away from you real fast on snow or ice, or on ice. Snow, it's just fine. It'll dig in, no problem. Ice, on the other hand, nah, it just slips all over the place with ice. Any other gripes? Yep, this cell phone holder, it just doesn't tighten up properly. It just doesn't. I'm gonna have to put a hole directly through where that screw goes into the plastic and put a bolt in there to get it to be on there secure. I don't have any gripes outside of that. None at all. I love this thing. Absolutely love it. It's so much fun. I'm taking it to work on working back. It's saving me some money on the bus. Yeah, 50 kilometers in, having a great time. We'll see what else happens with her today. Cheers.
the driver office. General, I gotcha. Oh, it's not Governor General, that's fucking, Can't do this shit on the bike. Oh no.